Good afternoon, welcome to channel 48. In this video, we're gonna install the latest Windows 10 onto an iMac. How to do it, how to get started, that is what I'm gonna show you in this video. Okay, welcome back. So, you have an iMac, Intel, and you have some operating system already installed on it. That would, of course, be the Mac OS, probably Leopard Snow, or maybe even Lion, and you're like, hey, my Safari is outdated, coming on YouTube telling me you need to update browser, but of course you're not getting any update qua browser from Apple anymore. Your system is saying fully updated, that while in fact it's not updated at all. So we found some nice solutions, and I show you how to install Linux onto these devices, and we learned that these devices are so happy thanks to foster parent Ubuntu and of course the clones Linux Mint etc. that are in fact responsible for making these devices great again. Okay, Apple made a great hardware device, but the software at a certain moment they pushed it away. Okay, they had to continue with the new devices. That's how companies work. It's normal. Otherwise, yeah, I don't know. But the hardware was at least very good that we, 14 years later, this one is 16 years old behind me, we can still use them and enjoy them in a great way. Even greater than people on these latest operating systems these days. Okay, that introduction was kind of long. So let me tell you what you're gonna need. You will need two USB sticks. Of course, one for the Windows 10 bootable that you're gonna create, okay? And another one to boot the Mac. So if you have Mac installed on the device, you can get started very easy by just going to the internet and look for Refit. Link, I will put a link in the description if I'm not lazy, but you should also not be lazy. Just type Refit or in Google, download the DMG, install it, reboot your device two times, and at the second time when you reboot, you're gonna see that you're gonna have a bootloader, a boot chooser, a boot selector. Okay, that is in fact what you kind of need to get started. However, if you have a Mac and in fact, it's not, you know, there is no operating system installed anymore. Yeah, then probably you're gonna see some folder that is flashing up and nothing is happening. The thing just keeps showing, you know, the folder with a question mark, I was saying. Then you can also do it differently. You can also get started immediately. What you will need if you're on a Windows computer is a little tool called TransMac. Go ahead and download, I think version 12 something, 12.1. Go ahead, download it. You can use it for, I think, a couple of days, okay? With the TransMac, you're gonna create a bootable Refit device. Yeah, you're gonna in fact restore your USB stick with that little Refit file that you will also find in my description. I will put them, make a little package, put them together, put them on my Mediafire, you know, so you can get started whenever you wish. So how does it work? Well, I'm gonna turn on that Windows machine. So I'm gonna show it really fast to you. Of course, you're gonna put in a USB stick. Okay. You're gonna find the software called TransMac. We start up TransMac with administrator rights. And here we say yes. No. It was already booting. And we say run. We say restore disk image with disk image. Can you read that there? Restore with disk image. And just say yes, and then up here you're gonna select, yeah, Refit 014, that's the DMG. Okay, just select it and create it. It will be created in a couple of seconds, and then you're gonna have a bootable Refit USB stick. The creation of the Windows 10 USB stick. Well, I do it with Power ISO, and I just finished mine. I'm gonna get it out. But what you should do is get Power ISO 4.9 and start it up with administrator rights. Yeah, you just find Power ISO, go ahead, install version. I should go for 4.9. It has no extra things into it, so it's kind of clean. Okay, and you right mouse click and say start run as administrator. You will get a pop-up and then boom, it's gonna be there. All right, and then you're gonna go to tools on top, you hit tools, and then create bootable USB drive. Select your ISO and hit start, and your USB stick will be created. Mine is done. So now we have a refit USB stick bootable, and we have the Windows 10 files. So let's get started. Okay, we put in the refit USB stick, and we put in the just freshly Windows 10 created USB stick in the iMac. The iMac is turned off. We're gonna turn it on, and we're gonna hold the Alt key. Keep holding the Alt key, and we should get into refit. You see refit there? We're just gonna select it, refit. Boom. What do we see? We see the Windows logo. So we can try the first one. It's saying not good. We should go for the last one. There, that one. Windows logo. Wait a second. Just wait. This is the black screen of waiting. I showed that I think some years ago already, and boom, Windows 10 is booting up to be installed on the iMac. We're just gonna hit next. Say install now. Hey, hello. You hear that? That was a bee. Came to say hello to me, and he fly away again. These are my friends. Yesterday one was stuck at the window. I put my hand beside it. It came and sit on my hand, and I put it outside. So up here you don't have to install no serial key. Just hit next. Not sure if it's possible. I have no product key. So here we can install all sorts of versions. 10S, 10SN. I don't even know what 10SN is. Home N, Home, Pro, Pro N. I think Pro N sounds something very special. What is Pro N? I have no idea what that is, man. It's been a while that I used Windows 10. We're just gonna go for Pro 10. Pro N, I mean. We accept the license, and we're gonna hit advance here. Which type of installer would you wish to do? Of course, this one here. And what we're gonna do here, guys, is we're gonna delete all the partitions. That is including the iGrape OS. We should have one partition left. This is it. Delete. Yes, there you go. You keep deleting until you have one partition left, and then you hit next. And now the installer will start, and Windows 10 will be installed to the system, to this iMac, this old iMac. This is just for testing, guys. Really, I'm not gonna keep this, but for all of you out there that, you know, love this and wanted this for so many years already, this is your chance. You can go ahead and also install the latest Windows 10, and let me show you how you can get this ISO while the installer is being performed.
What you do is you go to your search engine, And you type Windows 10 ISO download Microsoft. And then the third link, you're gonna see, make sure that it's saying Microsoft.com, okay? Don't go to any other site. Go to Microsoft.com with your Linux machine, okay? And then up here, you can select your edition, Windows 10, validating, choose one language, English or so, and then confirm. And here you can see a link valid for 24 hours from time of creation. Even though, you know, these links are for 24 hours valid, I'm not gonna share these links, because these links will not work after a couple of hours anymore. And then, yeah, it's better for you to find this page yourself. But you will not find it with a Windows computer, because that will bring you to the installation tool. But Microsoft wants everybody to be on Windows 10. So when you get there with the Linux machine, you know, the systems there will treat you as a special guest and say, hey, you are on Linux and you want to use Microsoft. So here, let me bring you to the ISO, you know, so that's how it works. Otherwise, you will never get to these two files here. Okay, so yeah, we're installing, guys. It's going nice and smooth. I got some mails, so I'm gonna read my mails and then I'm gonna get back when we're gonna reboot, and then you're gonna see the strangest boot of this iMac ever, guys. It rebooted. You should get some crazy thing. Yeah, there we go. I was waiting for this. This is very normal, guys. This is very normal. And yeah, now you can see that, yeah, in fact, I want to now demonstrate a boot up without these two sticks. We just remove them. Yeah, so this is now you're gonna see some crazy startup. We turn it on. I don't hear my gong anymore. It's gone. This machine don't like me anymore. I'm doing too many things with it. So take a look at, we get this folder. Yeah, the folder of craziness. And then just wait some seconds. Hold on, just wait. Boom! Look at that. Boom! Oh my gosh. And Windows 10 is booting up. And this will bring you to the setup. And you just install Windows 10 on a 15-year-old iMac. That's what you just did. So feel good about yourself, because you did it. You did the most craziest install ever on your iMac. And don't worry about that folder. Don't think that folder is gonna break your Mac that you see in the beginning that it's saying it's not good. Yes, it's not good for Mac OS X. But it's great for Linux, great for Windows, and any other operating system that will boot in that way on your iMac. So don't even worry, okay? Don't look at the folder, or just, you know, laugh at it. Yeah, just like how I do. So I'm gonna leave this to set the devices, and when we actually gonna be getting to the desktop, I'm gonna get back to you. Okay, we got to the just a moment part here. That's good to see. It's lovely. Mouse is working. Nice. It's been a while that I installed Windows 10, so I will see all the improvements that it went through all these years now, eh? In fact, because for at least 2 years I'm not checking on Windows 10 anymore, so I must also see how it is with Windows 10. Oh, look at the setup, this is nice. I never saw this before. So where am I? I'm in the Netherlands. Where is Netherlands? I don't see. Oh, there. Yes. What kind of language do they speak in the Netherlands? Dutch, of course. Dutch. Yeah. I love this setup screen, looks nice. Want to add a second keyboard layout? No. I never saw these parts yet. This is brand new to me. Let's connect to the network. No, skip for now. Name. iMac. Next. Password. No. No password. Okay, so location is on. Diagnostics on. Relevant ads. No. Off. 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 Speech recognition. Off. Off. Just for now. Because I don't know if I have sound and if all these things work. So. Oh, hi. We're getting everything ready for you. Okay, my friends. I will wait. Okay, guys. We're gonna start. Wow. This is it. Look at that. It's installed. And the first thing that we see is that the sound is not working. Not installed. Okay. Yeah, looks nice. Oh my gosh. Yeah. Looks nice. Wi-Fi is working. Yeah. What can I say? Nice. Ah, we can now change backgrounds. That is not locked anymore. Okay, good. Here you go, it works. Okay, but let's go to all settings. System. No. Control panel. This is what I need. The most important thing. Large icons. So, device manager, okay, what do we see? USB input device has a not a happy thingy there, and the sound is not working. So let's see if we can fix the sound. Driver, update driver, search automatically. The best driver is already installed. Okay, I still had a driver. I'm using the sound driver of my MacBook White, the 1.1. There was a guy long time ago. I think he was from I don't know where, and he gave me these drivers. It helped thousands of people. Eh? And now again, it's helping me. I just went to my MediaFire, just checked out the old video of mine. And I just fixed it, man. Look at that. We have sound. Many people are crying about sound. Look, we have sound. That's it. There's not much more to it. You can install Windows 10 on these iMacs out there. Mine is over 14 years old. And the only thing that you will need is, of course, the refit bootable USB stick and your bootable Windows 10 USB stick. Or maybe even CD, but I would use a stick. I would say be careful with doing too many crazy things on the device, because I'm not sure how it's gonna deal with the other hardware that in fact does not have no drivers. There are some parts in that Mac that have no drivers, but
everything important works. Screen works good, Wi-Fi works, sound works, network works. It all works. But some little parts in the system have an exclamation mark. I could not fix that yet. And I'm also not planning to fix them because I have another project waiting that need to be installed on that iMac. So yeah, in fact, installing Windows 10 on this machine was only and for this video and to give you the information how to do it. And then I want to say have a happy Friday the 13th. I hope that everything will be good out there with you. Be careful if you go on the street, go party, you know, wait for it to become Saturday the 14th before you go out of the house, right? Or are you not superstitious? Well, I'm also not superstitious. So good job, Microsoft. Good job, Apple, for the good hardware. Microsoft for the for the Windows 10 development, of course. Keep up the good work. And then I would love to say see you in my next video. That in fact gonna show the installing of a KDE Plasma desktop running on, of course, the mother operating system, the foster parent, Ubuntu, Linux Mint, one of these clones I'm gonna use. And we're gonna give it kinda the Windows 10 look and feels. Maybe we should call it Windows 13 because today is Friday the 13th. So yeah, maybe not. Maybe it will bring bad luck. Maybe we just call it iWindows 12 or iWindows 9. We just go one step back, so you know it's not above the 10, so we don't piss off nobody there at Microsoft, you know, as if we are showing some updated thing. We should keep the respect as well for them, right? So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna start creating, and then I love to see you in the next video. If you think this video was kind of cool, leave it a like, subscribe, and hasta la vista. Yeah.